Welcome back. If you've just tuned in, this is the Legacy Series, proudly brought to you by FBN Quest Trustees. And we're set to kick off discussions for today. I have with me in the building, Vice President, Business Development at FBN Quest Trustees, Rotimi Obende. Are you ready?
Yes, Sonny.
All right. Now, this one's from Amaka from Surulere. She sends this in. She says, part of my goal for the year is to set up a trust for my children, but my husband is not interested. What should I do? What can she do?
My advice to Amaka would be to create the trust, fund the trust by herself, let the trust run. Then after some time, have a conversation with her husband. Now, it's important to have the process started. And once she's able to achieve that, she can now bring the statement of account to her husband to say, this is what I've been talking about. She should also look for opportunities. So maybe the passing of a friend or a relative to have that discussion again with her husband. It's important to have his buy-in. However, just ensure that you have a trust in place that caters for the education of your children, and along the line, he will get interested.
Why do you think the husband's not interested? Is it a thing with us here in this part of the world, from your experience?
A bit of it, yes. The other part will be that when it comes to discussing estate planning, a lot of people just think that you're planning for their death, and it's something that the man, an African, would not want to have at that point in time. However, yeah, when you look at insurance products or other similar products,
yes,
if he understands the benefit of a trust arrangement and sees that the advantages far outweigh all the other products that people have for their children, I'm pretty sure that he will buy into it and he would have an education trust for his children.
Thank you for that, Rotimi. Now, the next question is from Tunde from Maryland. He says, my father bought majority of his properties in his first wife's name. He died suddenly without a will. He died intestate, yeah? And his wife has taken over all the properties without regard to children from the other wives. Is there anything we can do? Our father took care of us when he was alive. Wrote to me, this one is sad.
Again, Sonny, it's typically an estate planning method that has gone wrong. A number of people will probably have thought that if I buy property in the name of my wife and something happens to me, then my family members cannot gain access to it. However, the thinking behind what he's done has suddenly become a big issue. One would have expected that the wife would take care of the other kids. At this stand at the moment, it's pretty difficult for Tunde to be able to do anything. All the properties are in the name of the first wife. She can prove that she actually bought those properties using the husband. And so it's something that is a bit delicate. My advice would just be to other people out there, when crafting your estate plan, ensure that you use the proper instruments, ensure that the transfers are properly done. I would have suggested that the man set up a trust, buy his assets in the name of the trust, have all his children and future children, grandchildren, as beneficiaries of that trust arrangement. That way, nobody is in direct control apart from the trustee that manages the affairs of the estate and ensures that each beneficiary gets what they should get.
Great advice. Now, something came to mind. Do you think that her husband had a bit of trust, you know, in her? You know, that's why he made her the, you know, beneficiary, or is it beneficiary or the trustee?
Yeah, the beneficiary.
The beneficiary, yeah.
Now, a lot of trust issues, Sonny. Yes, he trusted her and he believed that she would be able to take care of the other family members. I'm sure that before the death of the man, she would have played that role very well.
Very
and
well.
Under that circumstance, it's difficult not to assign her that responsibility. It's also possible that the woman contributed to the success of the man from the beginning, and as a way of assuring her that we own this together, he would have done that. But again, it's not a method that would advise. Would ask that you create a trust arrangement, ensure that the first wife is a beneficiary, all your kids are beneficiaries, and outline the nature of benefits that you want them to enjoy.
To enjoy. And that's why it's so important that you bring in a third party, people who would experience, people with integrity, an institution like FBN Quest Trustees, you know, because relying on individuals, because people change, you know, so to avoid all of those, you know, unforeseen circumstances, that's why it's important that they contact the experts, right?
True, Sonny. The other angle I didn't want to talk about is the fact that, again, she probably had not seen that kind of wealth entrusted to her. And without the man being there at the moment, she just suddenly sees that she has acquired an empire and she wants to just manage it to her own benefit. I think it is really sad.
It's really sad. Well, Tunde, take heart. If you have any more questions or you want to do any more inquiry about this subject or any other one that bothers you, and same goes for everyone out there, please feel free, call the number 0805-400-0299. An expert is waiting to attend to your needs. The next question is from Obi from Aba. It says, I'm a businessman with many investments. I like to keep my money private and coded. I don't have a will or a trust because I feel it will expose me to the government and strangers. Am I doing the right thing? Please kindly advise.
Straight away, I'll say Obi is doing the...
But are there many like Obi out there?
Yeah, obviously. And Obi is just one of those that decided that he would speak out. And again, clearly, Sonny is not doing the right thing, and that's because he's putting not only himself, his business, and his family members into a tight corner, a tight fix if something should happen. Now, why not praying that debtor he becomes incapacitated? The point really is that in trying to run away from the government and strangers, you probably will meet them at the end of the day.
Exactly.
So if he dies today without a will or an estate plan in place, his estates will go through probate. At that point in time, his beneficiaries would have to get a letter of administration. That process in itself is time consuming. I like to say it's killing, plus the fact that they would have to incur additional expenses which he did not plan for. Now, if he has a trust in place, then he can put all of these assets into a trust and still be protected from the third parties and even the government. However, what would not advise is run away from paying taxes. You are running a legitimate business, you should pay taxes. However, it's important that you structure your business such that third parties are not involved, such that those you do not intend to take over the running of the business in future don't come in. And that's where I think that Obi is missing it. He needs to put a structure in place. He needs to stop running away from what ultimately he would still need to face. And so my advice would be, Obi, come sit with us. Let's come up with a structure that basically ensures that your assets are protected, there are no third party interferences, and you can continue to run your business the way you are currently running it.
So ultimately, there's no no need building a business that won't outlive you. I mean, if there are bottlenecks that you meet halfway, why not deal with them from get-go so that you don't, you know, have to deal with those issues on the long run?
You remember last year we talked about business succession planning.
Yes.
This is a typical example of how you should structure your business such that somebody else takes over the running of the business in future. He needs to do what is right.
Well, it's always a pleasure to have you, Rotimi Bende, on the Legacy Series.
You're welcome.
Now, we appreciate you for tuning in today on the Legacy Series. Contact FBN Quest Trustees for your estate plan and secure your tomorrow today. Keep a date with our same time, same station on the Legacy Series. Until then, my name is Sonny Emmanuel Franklin Alkali, saying do take it easy.
The Legacy Series, brought to you by FBN Quest Trustees.